Hey, Patty Abel with Abel Wellness, and today we're working on some equestrian movement in the studio. So my daughter and I both take riding lessons, and I know for me some of the things that I've found that I need to work on is one, that heel reach in the position into the saddle, and my inner thigh strengthening and the posting. Especially if you're in shoes a lot throughout the day, getting that drop of the heel in your stirrup is pretty challenging. So I'm using the Cadillac today and the chair so that I have some heel drop. So for me, you know, just this, and then I've also got the strap around my back. And then I have a strap here to hold on to, kind of mimicking the reins, but more stability for me right now. And I like this because it gives me some feedback into what's happening in my upper body. You know, if I'm flaring my ribs out and arching too much, or if I'm rounding forward, because I can feel this and keep my back flat. So what I like to do first is just drop the heels down and feel that heel drop. And with the long leg, it's not too bad. I'm already starting to think, you know, is my hips and my shoulders over my heels? And then from that position, slowly beginning to bend the knees like you're going into that more of a rider position. And as your knees bend, you're going to find that it's much more challenging to keep the heels down. So I'm getting a really nice big stretch in my heels, in my ankles, in my feet, in my calves. And I can feel my inner thighs working too. Here I can also pay attention to my shoulders, if, you know, if they're rolling back, if they're rolling forward. And I can even bring the strap down some, because when we're riding, our hands are a little bit more forward. And then from this position, I can just work on lowering into the squat a little bit and coming back up. So if I want to work even more on the inner thigh stretch or inner thigh strength while practicing this, I can put the Pilates circle in between my thighs, which gives a lot of work. And then from that, I'm squeezing into the circle, and I'm going to keep that squeeze as I drop my heels and then lower into that rider position. And then from here, I can come back up. I could even go down, and if I really wanted to work on that inner thigh strength, I could add some pulses into the circle. If I wanted to work my core strength a little bit more, I could release the straps. Ooh, no hands. And same thing. So now I'm having to draw my core in. I'm trying to reach those heels down, and it's hard work. So from there, another thing that I like working is, yeah, I'm also trying to work my posting right now. It's getting there, but it has some work to do on it. So I like to bring the sling down underneath my hip bones. I'm going to grab my support strap, or we'll call them the reins for right now. And I'm going to take my feet back out wide, because as we know, a horse does not have a narrow body and shoulders. Then we go out wide on my foot bar, and I find that squat position again. And then from here, I can just practice some tiny little pelvic tilts, same as if we were riding. So I'm working that lift of the belly up. And if I was on the horse, I would be getting that movement from the horse, we can, of course, step it up a notch and add in our ring of fire. And we can go back down again with that ring of fire and a little tip and back. And as we know, when we're on the horse, I know for me, I can feel a little bit more squeeze at certain times. So now I'm working on that heel drop, that inner thigh strength, and the core stability of being able to post. Again, we could drop the reins. And now we really have to work the core. And that is just a little taste of some of the stuff I've been working on to help better my own riding and others that come in to have us work with them. So, hope it helped. Would love to see you in the studio, and see you next time.